Guys, this is an example problem. Actually, this question is appeared in the 2012 and 2000 year for BCom students. I hope this will be helpful for us in understanding interest on securities topic, and we need to concentrate on this, understand the concept. Okay. Guys, I will read out this question. Compute income from other sources of Dr. Gokak, who held the following investments in the previous year, 18 and 19. First one is rupees 1,10,000, 10% central government securities. See, central government securities, which comes under the less tax free government securities, securities which are issued by central or state government. So, no grossing up, no TDS will be done. No grossing up, no TDS have been done by the central government. Whatever the investment you made, 1,10,000 rupees, on that 10% interest is fully taxable. Fully taxable. So, therefore, 10% investments on central government securities. So on 1,10,000, 10% is 11,000 rupees is fully taxable. Just we can make out here the securities, types of securities I have given, and any securities which are issued by state government or central government, directly we have to take the amount of investment with rate of interest, we have to tax it. Next one is 4,10% commercial securities. See, it's a commercial securities, that means non-government. If it is a non-government, what word we have to find out? Does the tax-free word is given or not? In this point, is not given tax-free word. If it is, there is no word tax-free, then they're all less tax-free. There are less tax free. So therefore, how you know TDS has done in case of less tax non-government, less tax government, similar treatment we have to give. So that means we need, there is no need of grossing up for less tax free. So therefore, on 10% commercial securities, on 4 lakhs, we calculate 10%, 40,000 is fully taxable, and there is no need of grossing up in case of less tax free. In case of, if the word tax free is not there, all such securities are called as less tax free non-government. Commercial is nothing but non-government. See, in this type of non-government less tax free securities, the security authority, the securities who are issued, okay, the authorities of securities who are issued, they will not deduct any taxes from that. They have not deducted any taxes. They will be given a gross amount to you. So therefore, we are taking a gross amount over there. 8,000 rupees gross received as interest on public limited company securities. So here, in the bracket it is given listed, whether it is listed or unlisted, please don't worry about it. So here, the interest amount is given, but it is given clearly that 8,000 rupees is the gross amount. If it is clearly given in the question, it is a gross amount, then there is no need of grossing up. So therefore, interest on Public Limited, 8,000 rupees, since he is given gross. If the word gross is not given, then we would have taken 8,000 divided by 90 into 100, because 10% taxes would have been deducted from that. In this case, no tax is deducted because the word gross he himself is given. Next one is 7,200 received as interest on Karnataka government securities. See, here interest amount is given. and it is a Karnataka government securities. It is issued by the state government. It is issued by the state government. No need of grossing up, no TDS is required. So therefore, interest on government of Karnataka amount is 7,200 rupees, fully taxable. 3,600 received as interest on XYZ Limited. See, this is amount of interest is given. It is not issued by state government or central government. It is issued by a company. And there is no word tax free. And there is no rate also given in the question. If rate is not given, if the amount of interest is given, if the amount of interest is given, interest is given, always we need to cross up. So therefore, XYZ Limited, the amount is 3,600. So always we need to gross up. See, if 100 rupees is the gross amount you earn, 10% taxes would be deducted and 90% or 90 rupees of the interest will be given to you. So this 3,600 is a net amount which is given, net amount of 90. What is for 100% of gross amount is? So 4,000 rupees is the interest amount. Okay guys, next is rupees 3 lakhs 13.5% securities of X Limited. See, here also the word tax free word is not given. What is the difference between fifth point, fifth adjustment and the sixth adjustment is? In the fifth adjustment is given amount of interest is given, but in the sixth adjustment is given rate of interest also is given, and also amount of investment also is given. So therefore, what I do is interest on X Company Limited on 3 lakh rupees, rate of interest is 13.5%, directly it is taxable. So thereby on 3 lakh rupees, 13.5% is 40,500, which is fully taxable. Hope all of you are understanding. See, if the word tax free word is not given in case of non-government, see, X Company is a non-government. It's a non-government, number one. Second one is the word tax free word is not there. So therefore, whatever the amount of investment and rate is given, just multiply it and calculate the interest, that would be the gross amount. Because in this case, this X Company is not deducted any taxes. They have given gross amount to the investor. So therefore, we have to charge full amount. Next is rupees 3,50,000, 11% securities of a paper mill company. See, a paper mill company is a non-government company and the word tax-free is not given. So therefore, we write interest from paper mill company, 3,50,000 into 11%, 3,50,000 into 11%, which comes to 38,500. So next is interest on post office savings bank account, 6,500. See, if you look at here, any interest on post office savings bank account which is exempted up to 3,500, but in this question he earned an interest on post office savings bank account as 6,500. So therefore, interest on POSB account, means post office savings bank account, he earned 6,500, exempted is 3,500, and remaining 3,000 rupees is taxable. Okay guys, next is dividend received from Corona Limited, 32,000 gross. So Corona Limited, say the word limited company is only happens in India. The word we call all such companies as limited companies in India. Any dividends received from Indian company or a domestic company which are completely exempted, already we have discussed. So therefore, dividend from Corona Limited is exempt. So these are the points which is given, and is given some additional adjustments also. For the purchasing securities of X Limited, he took a loan of ₹2,50,000 at 12% per annum. This loan was taken from his friend in UK. The interest has been paid to UK, but no TDS has been done. See, I told you in the earlier videos, in the previous video, any interest amount which you are paying to someone without deducting taxes. See, you have taken a loan of ₹2,50,000 and paid 12% interest to a person from whom you borrowed, who is in UK. So when you are paying any interest amount outside India, you need to deduct the taxes from that. You need to deduct taxes from that, but you have not deducted any taxes from that. So thereby, which is fully what? Taxable here in case of interest on loan, no TDS is done on 2,50,000, on 2,50,000, 12%, 30,000 rupees is taxable. On 2,50,000, 12%, okay, 30,000 rupees is fully taxable. All of you understood, guys? So now, during the year, he also got a prize in Karnataka lotteries, and the net amount received by him is 2,80,000. Okay, he won winning from lottery from state government of Karnataka worth of 2,80,000 rupees, and no taxes deducted from that. Okay, now let us see. So here I'll write 11th point here. Winning from lotteries, 2,80,000 net amount is given. Net is 70. What is for 100? Because any casual income, TDS will be 30%. Tax rate is 30%. So if you won some amount of winning from lottery, 30% taxes would be deducted and 70% will be paid to you. Now 70%, which is equals to how much? 2,80,000. What is for 100? Is 4 lakh rupees. Is 4 lakh rupees. Now from here to till here, if you calculate, you will get income from other sources. Now let us calculate 4 lakhs plus 11,000 plus 40,000 plus 8,000 plus 7,200 plus 4,000 plus 40,500 plus 38,500 plus 3,000 plus 30,000. So totally 5,82,200. 5,82,200. This is called as income from other sources. Guys, it's not a too difficult question. Only thing is, see, investment from central government, it's issued by central government, no TDS is there, directly we have charged. 10% commercial securities, since the word tax-free word is not given, all such securities becomes less tax and no TDS will be there then, and no need of grossing up. 4 lakh rupees, 10% we calculate. And interest on public limited, so he is given the word gross amount, he is given in the question, so therefore I am talking 8,000 rupees. Interest on government of Karnataka issued by state government of Karnataka, it is a less tax-free government securities which is fully taxable because no need of grossing up, no TDS have been done. Next is interest on XYZ Limited. XYZ Limited is a commercial non-government securities. The word tax-free word is not given, so therefore 3600 amount of interest is given and always we need to gross up. If the rate of interest is also given, if the amount of interest is given, we need to gross up. Okay, it is a less tax-free, but what is given? The amount of interest is given. It's not a tax-free securities. It is a less tax-free, but is not given the percentage, but is given the amount of interest. If the amount of interest is given, in case of less, it is a less tax-free, we need to gross up. Next is interest on X Company Limited. X Company Limited is a commercial non-government securities. Since the word tax-free is not there, we are calculating directly on 3 lakh rupees. Okay. Interest on Paper Mill Company. Paper Mill Company is a less tax-free non-government. There is no word tax-free. Directly I am calculating. In case of interest on Post Office Savings Bank account, he earns 6,500. But up to 3,500 is exempted, rest of the amount is taxable. Next is dividend from an Indian company, Corona Limited, is nothing but an Indian company which is exempted. Interest on loan, okay, interest on loan, 250,000 rupees of loan borrowed from a friend who is in UK, for whom we paid 30,000 rupees of interest. On such interest amount of 30,000, no TDS was done, so therefore full amount 30,000 rupees is taxable. And finally, winning from state government of Karnataka lotteries, net amount is given as 2,80,000 and it is for 70%, what is for 100% is 4 lakhs. So all these incomes with the 4 lakh, 5,82,200 is the total income from other sources. Thank you guys.